Well, we were about to leave for the second half of this tour and noticed that the trailer was about to have some serious leaf spring issues. Got some broken pieces down there.
Sure. So the night after the hometown show, we were about to leave Illinois to start heading out west to meet up with Trapped again. And we are literally about to pull out the driveway, and for some reason I was walking back to the bus from inside to get something, I guess, and I just kind of just glanced at the trailer, like between the wheels, and I noticed something looked kind of weird.
There was something hanging down from our trailer, and it ended up being a really big issue that my dad had to come out at on a work night and weld some new parts, just like make some new parts out of metal. Don't know how it does it for our trailer.
Kristen's dad is awesome at doing everything, so he like welded us a whole new trailer pretty much. Well, the first breakdown we had, we were driving to Boston, which I was really excited about because I grew up on the streets of Boston. We broke down a couple times on this tour. Once was in Pennsylvania, had a leaky spark tube. No, we had a, well, basically,
yeah.
That's actually,
that's pretty much what it was.
We actually broke down in Scranton, Pennsylvania. We had to rent a van off of Craigslist last minute to drive 5 hours to Boston. We got there like 20 minutes before our set, played the show, packed up, drove 5 hours back to Scranton to pick up our fixed bus and then make it to a show in Albany, New York that night. So it definitely wasn't a fun night, but it was cool that everyone kind of came together and toughed it out.
So we're about to get towed, breakdown number two of the trap tour, and anyway.
They knew this tour would have so many breakdowns.
Yeah, I know, right?
And we broke down, what, 3 times we ended up breaking down? It was pretty crazy.
We broke down on tour. That was a thing. Actually, more than once.
Breakdown number two was in New Mexico, and the towing situation with that breakdown was a little more hectic.
We just called a tow truck driver to come pick us up from this travel center that we're at. And he arrives, and he takes 2 steps out of his truck, and he says, "Hey, I can't do this." He said, "Why?" He said, "Well, it's just going to be too hard. It's too much of a liability. I'm not doing it. I don't want to mess with it."
He left.
He left. He drives away.
He left us.
So we call someone else. Nate says, "Hey, the tow truck driver's going to be here in like 10 minutes. We need to get our stuff together so we can just move out and go to wherever we need to." And Kristen's currently on the phone with this tow truck driver saying that he also cannot do it.
That's what's happening
right now. He cannot come. So we are officially living in the bus.
It all kind of turned into a blur after a while because it just got so ridiculous. Like, you're thinking, wow, here we are in New Mexico in this town called Moriarty.
There was actually a gas station that we got the bus to with a Carl's Jr. inside of it that was hiring. And so there was a brief moment there where we discussed the possibility of just having to live in the stranded bus and get jobs at this gas station until we saved up enough money to be able to like fly the bus home or something to get it fixed.
Okay, so the second tow truck driver, who was actually the fourth, he was nice enough to actually let us ride in his cab of his truck all the way to our next location, which was like 2 hours away. All four guys were sitting on his bed in the cab,
which had car sheets on it.
Which did have car sheets on it, which was cool because we were on Route 66, so it made sense.
So this is it.
This is our life. I said just picked up this new addition about 10 minutes ago, so our rig is a little bigger now.
I did make friends with the truck driver,
while Kristen sat up in the front and just asked question after question to this poor guy.
He really enjoyed my conversation, so I think we definitely made friends. He'd definitely help us out again. Yeah.
Luckily, everything worked out. Some good people hooked us up, and we didn't have to live in New Mexico for a couple years. Yeah, so we rolled with punches. We just took the cards that were dealt to us and played them as best we could.
I literally, a couple months ago, had just got back from vacationing in San Francisco, and I'm like, oh my gosh, you guys, I'm so excited. This is our first time playing in San Francisco. It's gonna be amazing.
We were a little bit late, so we pulled up to the front of the venue and we loaded in real fast. Nate drove the bus around the corner, parked it. We went in the sound check. We were literally inside for like 35, 40 minutes tops. We come back outside to the bus door open, which was previously locked before. We walk in and we're like, well, everything's still here. The TV's here. The Xbox is here. They didn't take anything.
And we just got robbed. Just really, really bad. So that was something.
Our clothes were on the floor. Kristen's wallet's gone. Her phone's gone. Nate's backpack's gone. You know, my iPad's gone. Kristen's iPad and all this stuff. Nate's computer. Everything.
I got legitimately worried because all the guys got so mad that the stuff was stolen, they just kind of like started trying to figure out where they went.
I had that Find My iPad thing on my, like on my phone and on my iPad. So if it's on, I can track it. So I realized that. I turn it on and I see that they're like a 10-minute walk away from us and it's moving on the map. And I'm like, all right, let's do this.
They were like looking for weapons and stuff in the bus in the full retaliation mode. They were just gonna go, you know, get our stuff back, beat the crap out of these people and get our stuff back.
I think somebody grabs a knife. I got a really large crescent wrench about this big and tried to fit it in my pocket. And next thing you know, we're on the move and we are gonna get our stuff back because you don't mess with Darling Parade.
I just sat in the bus and cried. And Chad, you were calling the police, I think. And they didn't answer. So it was a really bad area.
We got like probably within a block of them. And next thing you know, my iPad somebody turns it off. So my conclusion is I was texting my girlfriend, telling her what was happening and that we were looking for them. And then I was tracking it. And my iPad was also getting the text back from her so they could see the conversation, and they realized it and turned it off so we couldn't track it anymore. The rest of the night we were like afraid to leave the bus unguarded, obviously, and so when everyone went in to play their set for the show that night, I actually stayed back in the bus. So I kind of turned the lights off and hid in the back and left the door prop like how they had it, just kind of hoping that they would maybe come back and we could catch them. And I was just sitting back there with our fillet knife. I wasn't scared though, because I grew up on the streets of San Francisco, so it wasn't a big deal at all.
I think overall it ended up being okay because our fans really pulled through for us. And when we were just like, we just got done breaking down, you know, and like our vehicle was having problems, and then that happens. It's like, man, what else can go wrong on this tour? But I think overall it ended up being a cool experience just to see like the kind of support that we have and the friends that we have in this industry and the people that are supporting us. It's pretty cool.
That is the biggest mountain in America.
That's the volcano.
We should probably get out of here for
it. Yeah, let's go.
Volcano Everest.
This looks pretty awesome.
Yeah?
Water right now.
The bus broke down again. Idea. Sorry. You step back.
Hey! 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 Hey!